And this year, the New York Rangers and New York Islanders renew their rivalry, which the Islanders have dominated. The Rangers' moment of glory came in 1979 when they won in the semifinals. The last playoff meeting between these two teams was 1984, and it ended with Kenny Morrow's overtime goal winning the five-game series for the Islanders, who finished first that season while the Rangers finished fourth. This season, the roles are reversed. The Rangers won the Patrick Division, finishing first for the first time in 48 years. It puts them in the favorites role. But the Islanders have plenty going for them. They won the games they had to at the end of the season and made the playoffs as the fourth place team. Now comes the showdown with the Rangers. It's the New York playoff battle. Game one of the best of seven series between the Rangers and the New York Islanders tonight.
Madison Square Garden Network presents New York Rangers Hockey. Brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. By the professionals at Payne Weber. And by Today's TWA. Find out how good we really are.
Welcome live to Madison Square Garden. It's playoff time, and the Patrick Division semifinals opens up with the New York Rangers meeting the New York Islanders. Hello, everyone. I'm Sam Rosen, along with John Davidson. Bruce Beck joins us in just a moment, and this is what it's all about. The excitement is building. The fans' emotions are up. The players are excited in the hallway outside the locker rooms. They were really anxious to get going.
I think both these teams would love to have started this series yesterday, Sam. Instead, they had to wait and watch the other conference play. Both teams, though, had an extra chance to practice and prepare and get some of the aches and pains out of the systems. Both teams very well prepared for the series.
The Rangers finished first. The Islanders finished fourth. But sometimes, John, that's not a good sign. Three times in the last 4 years, number four has knocked off number one.
And just look at the playoffs last night, Sam. Three road teams win of the four games last night. Three upsets in the first game. Los Angeles and Calgary, probably the biggest. So you just never know. The Rangers worked hard to attain first place all season. Now, remember this. The Islanders only lost one of their last four games right to the Rangers this season. I expect a very, very close series.
Important move. Mike Richter starts for the Rangers in game one. It's the first time he started against the Islanders.
All season, right. Van Beesbrouck started the previous seven games during a regular season. I concur with Roger Nielsen's decision. Of course, he could have picked either Van Beesbrouck or Richter. They both, I'm sure, well prepared and both would play well. And I feel that if Richter has a very strong performance tonight, he'll get the call for game two. The Rangers have worked hard to get home ice advantage. They want to keep it.
We talked about how important Pat LaFontaine is to the New York Islanders. Bernie Nichols is equally as important for the New York Rangers.
Bernie Nichols, of course, one of the leading goal scorers. Here we see the Rangers moving out to the ice surface to a huge, huge ovation here. Towels waving, handed out to the fans. Bernie Nichols has got to have a good, strong performance, Sam, for the Rangers to do well here. He's part of the attack. They need him.
As the Rangers hit the ice, we'll go to ice side to get some of the feeling from Bruce Beck.
Madison Square Garden is alive. This may be the start of the Stanley Cup playoffs, but for New York fans, this series is where it's at. This is the story of two teams who don't like each other, of loyal fans who despise the other team as much as they embrace their own club. The emotions run high tonight. The butterflies are in the bellies of the players, coaches, and fans. This is more than just a hockey game. It's a happening. It's one of the great rivalries of all of sports. Yes, indeed, a love affair tonight at Madison Square Garden as the Stanley Cup playoffs commence between the New York Rangers and the New York Islanders. And you know, the circus is currently on a pretty good run at Madison Square Garden, but tonight, in the big tent, in the main ring, hockey Milwaukee takes center stage. Two clubs with dreams of winning the Stanley Cup playoff. We'll come back to Madison Square Garden in a moment.
And on their feet. Towels handed out and ready for this showdown series. Mark Fitzpatrick gets the call for the New York Islanders in game one.
And the Rangers will try to get to Fitzpatrick to try and crowd the goalie. If he does have a weakness or a weaker part of his game, it's the fact that he does not handle a puck extremely well. So the Rangers will try and work him deep.
One rookie for the Islanders, one rookie for the Rangers.
And Mike Richter with his second playoff start. He started the fourth game of the Pittsburgh Rangers series last season. And Sam, as far as save percentage goes, the Rangers 889, the Islanders 893 over the regular season.
Don Koharski is the referee tonight. Mark Pare and Dan Schachty are his linesmen. The Rangers open up with Bernie Nichols centering for Chris Nyland and Troy Mallette, with James Patrick and Norman Rochefort on defense. Pat LaFontaine with Brian Trotche on his right, Patrick Flatley on his left. You look at Roger Nielsen, Gerald Dittick, and Jeff Norton on defense, and we're underway in game one.
And these two coaches both started lines that aren't lines. They're not normally put together.
Norton brings the puck out and plays it in the Rangers' zone. The bouncer is stopped by Richter. He holds it with Trotche coming down.
And already the Islanders changing on the fly as Flatley went to the bench. And Mike Richter gets the call here, Sam.
In the game last season when he started against the Penguins, it was game four. The Rangers were down 3-0. He was shaky early. He settled down and played very well the remainder of the game. Rangers fell behind, lost the game 4-3, coming back late in that game.
But he did settle down. Again, I'll mention those save percentages. The Rangers' three goaltenders over the season, a fine save percentage today, 8.89. The Islanders 8.93 between the two of them, even a higher percentage. They had more shots to handle than what the Rangers goaltenders had over the regular season.
Bernie Nichols, who had a superb playoff last year for the LA Kings against the Calgary Flames. And the Edmonton Oilers, where the Kings beat the Oilers and went on to meet Calgary. Hard hit from Trotche as he knocked down Rochefort.
A good, solid hit. The best hit early here, Sam. And Rochefort had to play the puck, had his head down, and Trotche hit him clean.
Puck sent all the way down. Icing waved off. The Rangers have to play the puck.
Now you'll notice LaFontaine started the game. The Rangers had Rochefort and Patrick on the ice. The Rangers will always have their experienced defenseman on the ice against LaFontaine.
With Patrick leaves the puck behind the net. It's Morgan Nyland with a collision with Ken Baumgartner. Brent Sutter has the puck. Sutter on with Dakota and Bullock. Stick save made by Richter. And Moeller clears the zone out. The Islanders are hitting. Erlen did it across the line against Freshman. Moeller looks around. Up the boards, Brent Sutter trying to center. Missed it. Turcotte brings it down. Gary Nyland is there. Quick wrist shot is stopped. As they shoot low. King shanked that one. Played aside by Crosby for Flatley. He's hit from behind. Flatley trying to move down to the zone. He's caught up by Rochefort. And again hit by King on Flatley. Crosby wraps up. Turcotte takes it for the boards. Gardner was tripped up on the play, but the Islanders come around with the puck. Gary Nyland lost control. Moeller missed it. King comes over to help out.
Both teams have played five defensemen to this point. Granstrand has not seen the ice for the Islanders. And Bloomberg has not seen the ice yet for the Rangers.
Rechter fires it in. It's knocked down. Rodnick lost it, but Mullen keeps it in. Blocked in front. And the Islanders bring it out. Norton slides it across to Randy Wood. Horschel there. Wood with a shot. Hits Horschel. Rolls around by Mullen. Mullen carrying Kissio on his right. O'Brodnick on his left. Big shot. High off the glass. Mullen again. Deflected. Up into the crowd it goes. Play stops. 17-24 to go. First period, game one. There's no score. Some of the players on the Islanders, most of them feel the big difference is Al Arbor. Well, he turned his team around.
Don Mahoney speaks so highly of Al Arbor, saying that not only does he teach, but he has great communication skills. And when you combine the both, the two of them, that could make you a great coach. And Al Arbor, we all know, is a great coach.
Jansen's Erickson, Nylund, Rochefort, and Patrick on for the Rangers.
This is the first time we've seen Erickson on the ice opposite the Fontaine. He then skated over to the bench, and Al Arbor said, stay on. So we're seeing all kinds of different matchups here, Sam. The Islanders have totally changed their lines from the way they finished the season.
Rochefort takes the Fontaine. Good hit by Allen. Kerr on Patrick. Rangers able to clear the zone. Islanders have the Fontaine on with Kerr and Derek King. Jeff Gordon seeing that. Roughing at 3:18.
The Fontaine is the man that will get the elbow or the punch to the face here. He tries to hold up Nylund, and there's Nylund swatting LaFontaine across the side of the head as he moves in forechecking. Nylund with the penalty in the offensive zone. LaFontaine now will lead the number one road rank power play over the regular season. Number two overall, number one on the road.
They scored 78 power play goals this season to the Islanders. 42 on the roll. Meanwhile, the Rangers come away with a puck. Rochefort setting it down. Jansen's has kicked the penalty call. It's on Ben Sutter for interference. That ends the Islander power play. 11 seconds after the Rangers took the penalty, Brent Sutter goes off.
It's an interference call. Rochefort works the puck deep as his team is shorthanded. And there you see Sutter knocking down Jansen's and then appealing. Don Kaharski makes the call.
Interference is called. Jansen's helped it out with a good dive.
Sure.
Went down pretty well.
Teams will skate four aside.
Rangers, by the way, had Kaharski as a referee just four times over the regular season, winning two and losing two. And Kaharski will work number three, the third game of the Toronto St. Louis series next. So now we have teams at even strength. And Kelly Kissio, Brian Mullen, trying to get on the ice here.
Well, they were on earlier for a show.
Get some more ice time is what I meant.
Kissio against LaFontaine. Kissio, Mullen, Rochefort, and Patrick for the Rangers. LaFontaine with Wood. Crossman. And Nylund. Long shot by Patrick to flip the wide of the net. Glenn Mullen keeps it in. Kissio in the corner looking for Mullen. He's cutting short of net. Kissio still has it along the boards. Double team. This pass blocked. Rochefort able to keep it in. Now Gary Nylund.
Islanders right now have a lot of speed on the ice in LaFontaine and Randy Wood.
Pass missed connection. Rochefort setting it back in. Nylund. Crossman gets away from Kissio and wheels back away from Mullen. Randy Wood. Trottier's on now with Randy Wood. Patrick is there. Comes it up the boards, went back to Kissio. We're checking with Brian Trottier. Teams are skating four aside. 15:35 to go on. First, there's no score. Flatley takes it back. Puts it into the Rangers zone. Richter leaves it for Randy Mullen. Ryan Mullen moves around Jeff Gordon. Comes in against Gerald Dennett. Takes the shot. Stick save made by Fitzpatrick, who wins it around. Trottier in the corner.
Every shot by the Rangers so far, Fitzpatrick. Two have registered. A couple have been wide. Have been low.
Rangers changing. Mike Trottier comes on. Loose pass Trottier. Then it's taken away by
tackles. McDonough did not get the puck out of the zone, and the Rangers score at first.
Rangers going to the net for rebounds, and Bernie Nichols found one. Nichols. Should be from Gardner and Muller at 5:14.
Nichols is first for Muller at 5:14.
Acquisitions in major trades. Nichols and Gardner, the high scoring forwards, combined to produce the first goal in the series. Rangers have the extra man on for a short stint, and now the teams are back at full strength. Technically, each team is 0-1 on the power play.
Sam, to watch when each team has a man in the penalty box, the forward side on the ice to watch the speed players work.
Brent Sutter shooting just wide. Quick shot by Brent Sutter. Checking James Packer. Tipped away. Nichols has it. Packer throws the play on the right side. Nichols shoots and it's blocked. Nichols shoots again. Deflected wide. The Islanders come out. Big proponent of the draw. Along with Don Maloney and Hubie McDonough. Packer pounded by Maloney. Maloney to the bump along the boards. Kept in by Kent Baumgartner. Long shot deflected by Bernie Nichols. Went wide to the net. Kept in by McCullough. Around the board for McDonough. McCullough back down by Nichols.
Rangers really throwing the body around here. 5 or 6, maybe even 7 good checks. And now they have a retaliation penalty.
Now it's McCullough.
McCullough takes the penalty, knocking down Maloney. Sam Maloney earlier threw a big body check on Don Maloney. And the Rangers now will have the chance to go on the power play.
Rangers get an extra man on.
Dakota's looking to start anything he can out there, realizing the Islanders have been out hit early here in the first period. The whole thing started with a big, big check. Millette hitting Don Maloney, and then Dakota on the other side of the ice. Slashed. Here we have Baumgartner 9.
This is Dakota going to the penalty box. He took the penalty behind the play on Troy Millette, and Baumgartner and Nyland squared off. They were separated by the linesman. 13:25 to go in the first period. Rangers
are back. 50-point game.
We now move ahead in the action.
Randy Moeller called for slashing at 15:32.
You'll see LaFontaine move the puck here, and there's the original check. Now King sees it was LaFontaine that got knocked down, so he goes right over and goes at Moeller. Watch Moeller stick here as he reacts with the wave. King protects himself, and Kaharski has been consistent in calling anything high with the sticks here in the first period. The one on Dinnick, the one on Moeller, they didn't connect, but they were up.
Third power play for the Islanders. Roll for two. Rangers with Erickson, Janssens, Rochefort, and Patrick on the ice. Islanders have Randy Wood, Brent Sutter, Pat LaFontaine, Doug Crossman, and Jeff Gordon. Crossman with it. Puts it down the boards for LaFontaine. Rochefort is there. Around the boards across the door. In the corner, Randy Wood. Pass LaFontaine to Crossman. Down low for Randy Wood in the corner. Now LaFontaine. Back for Wood. Now to Crossman. Islanders move the puck nicely. Set up in front is Brent Sutter, who was knocked down. That shot off the glove of Richter. LaFontaine broke his stick. Has to go get a new one. Meanwhile, the Rangers walk it down the ice. Janssens goes for it. He shoots quickly.
LaFontaine has leveled in front of Mike Richter. Yeah, that's at least 3 times this period. The Rangers have knocked LaFontaine flat.
Across the line from Wood, leaving it for Brent Sutter. Goes back to Crossman. Again, good passing. Now it's down the line. Comes out with Kissio. Norton is back. Kissio wheels back and kills some time. Good control by Kissio. Leads to Muller. 40 seconds to go. The Islander power play. The penalty killer by both teams thus far in the first period.
Muller, Carroll, Muller, and Kissio have had great, good success in the first period killing penalties.
Norton carries, left it along the boards. Took that bucket for granted. 5 seconds to go in the Islander power play. 2:50 to go in the first period. Rangers lead 1-0. Gerald Dinnick moving out. Derek King. Richter. Plays it around. Captain defense goes up. Turcotte moves around and out of the zone. Erickson gets the puck. Erickson moves across. Erickson shoots it. It's blocked by Norton. Turcotte taken down on the play. Turcotte has the puck. Trying to come out in front. Turcotte turns. The Couldn't get a shot off. Brick takes it back. Teams are back in full strength. There's a lead off the stick on the front page. Rick Gustafson.
It's amazing the shots are 9-5 in favor of the Islanders. And if you consider all the power play time, that's not many that have registered. There's been a lot of shots blocked at both ends.
Nylund and Gardner going to the corner. Rangers leading 1-0 with 2 minutes remaining in the first period. Bernie Nichols turns. It's blocked by Hughie McDonough. Comes out with Maloney on his left and Allen to her right. Maloney against Bowler. Center across for McDonough. Tied up by Horchow.
Takes a look at college basketball, the NCAA wrap-up, 7:30 tomorrow night on MSG Network. Alan Kerr goes off, and the Rangers get their fourth power play of the game. Kerr for roughing at 19:41.
Mike Richter with an outstanding first period. He had very little work over the first 5 or 6 minutes, and then flurries of shots, most of them through all kinds of traffic. The Islanders had great success in their last win over the Rangers in the island by driving to the net, getting rebounds, screening the goaltender. And one of Richter's strengths, maybe his best strength, Sam, is he's able to stop the puck through all kinds of screens.
They've gone to the net somewhat, but I think what the Rangers are doing successfully, John, is slowing them up a little bit in the neutral zone.
Doing their best. And I also think the Rangers, and they've had a lot of pressure in their zone over the last 10 minutes of this period, as they've taken away the slot from the Islanders by clogging it up in front of Richter and making them try to shoot from the outside.
Nichols brings his power play. They're 0 for 3. All the way down it goes. This power play will carry over to the second period. And a standing ovation for the New York Rangers here at Madison Square Garden. Mike Richter stops 10 shots. Bernie Nichols gets the only goal. It came at 5:14. And at the end of one, in game one, it's the Rangers one and the Islanders nothing. Bruce will be talking.
Now move ahead in the action.
Pat LaFontaine.
You'll see LaFontaine moves to the neutral zone and watch the Rangers think about trying to hit him. Here comes Moore up the ice. And how he avoids checks right here. Moeller's been on the ice opposite LaFontaine a lot, as has Rochefort or Patrick, the more experienced Ranger defenseman, and they've done their best to try and hit LaFontaine. The longer the series, the more those hits will take effect.
Nichols, Gardner, Millett, Rechter, and Patrick on the ice for the Rangers. down and Wooden. Lead for Bullock. Coming through, slides it across. First side of the shot. Kick save. Zone 16:20 to go in the second period, and Nichols with some little chit chat, some jokes. Talking, no doubt about Bernie Nichols, the physical player.
He has been physical.
He really has.
In Washington, the Saturday before the season ended, he threw a lot of body checks. He threw three or four in the first period here. Here's a two-on-one. It's a neutral zone turnover, and you'll see Volek and Sutter work the two-on-one on Greschner. Sutter's wide. It's a rolling puck. And Richter, showing good quickness and smart positioning, makes a save. Nichols then went into Randy Wood.
Rick Richter with a real good save on that shot.
LaFontaine
is out shooting the Rangers 11-7.
LaFontaine double shifted a lot. Here you'll see LaFontaine play on a line with Wood and Trottier on the left wing. We're not seeing Trottier at center ice here. The Islanders addressing one fewer forward than what they do normally, going with 11 and dressing seven defensemen.
Fontaine, good work on the faceoff. Finley is on the ice for the first time in the game for the Islanders. Finley having a breakout penalty call. Finley called for holding. He grabbed Kissio with one arm to play the puck. Takes the penalty, and the Rangers get another power play chance. 16:09. Mike Richter, he was a lifesaver there for the Rangers.
You'll see the work of Sutter and Flatley in deep. The puck will be moved in front, and this is the big save right there. As Horschel was all over Volek, he was still able to get the shot on goal. The Islanders continue to get to the loose pucks, and that's another big save. That time off of Sutter. Two big, big saves during that flurry.
Remember, when you're having good times with good friends, use good sense and drink responsibly. Please, know when to say when. A reminder from Anheuser-Busch. 11:07 to go in the second period. Rangers leading 1-0.
That was such a flurry that Nyland, the defenseman, had his stick and hands up in the air. He thought the puck had gone in behind on the Volek shot. He was about to celebrate a goal.
Kissio, Grodnik, and Mullen on the ice with Rochefort and Patrick.
Both these teams, Sam, are schooled very well in what to do, win or lose the draw. A lot of tie-ups. How to go after a loose puck in case of losing. You see LaFontaine just hit Rochefort. Lots of body work after losing the draw.
Ryan Mullen with some room. Brings it across. Baumgartner came over. Grodnik sends it in and wide the net. Kissio tied up along the boards. Grodnik passed the puck to Kissio. He shot blocked by Dinner. The Islanders come out. Randy Wood with a puck. Trailing is Brian Trottier. Wood going wide. Round Rochefort. He's in. Save Bane.
Stick and a penalty shot called. Rochefort was beaten because of the speed of Wood. Watch his stick. He simply lets it go here and throws it right now. That is without a doubt a penalty shot. An excellent call by Don Baharski. And Sam, a similar play last night in Calgary. Kuzmanowski threw a stick. Al MacInnis was awarded the penalty shot and he scored. So Mike Richter, who was 2-for-2 on the season stopping penalty shots, has his biggest test yet.
The Rangers questioning the call. Ron Greschner, Darren Turcotte, and Kelly Kissio over there. Excuse me, that's Brian Mullen, not Darren Turcotte. Koharski explaining the reasons for his call, and I believe it's a good call.
Absolutely, there's no doubt. That is the call, that's the play. It was very evident. And now the Islanders have themselves a penalty shot, the second in their history. The first one by Denny Potvin way back on April 9th, '83 against Washington. He did not score against Pat Riggin.
Mark Perret as they again consult. There have been 19 penalty shots in the Stanley Cup playoffs. The shooters going 6-for-19.
One thing about Randy Wood now is he does things with a lot of speed. I don't think Wood, I think it may be an option. question that the Islanders have as to who takes the penalty shot, and it looks like LaFontaine. And I feel if it's LaFontaine, he's likely now. The Islanders tried. The Islanders tried. They tried to get LaFontaine. Randy Wood is now called off the bench. And he was the man who was in control of the puck when it happened. And what does a person sound when he comes in and uses speed? Let's see if he panics and varies and slows down and gives the goaltender a better chance.
I know LaFontaine's super, but he's not Superman. He couldn't switch jerseys fast enough.
Look at this, though. He's giving advice to Randy Wood as to what to do. On the play. We're nearly at the midway point here. It's 1-0 Rangers, and there's a penalty shot coming up. Now, Richter has to stay in his goal crease until the puck is touched at center ice. He cannot move out of the goal crease prior to it.
And final instructions for Randy Wood from Don Koharski. Always a dramatic moment in a regular season game, heightened here in the playoffs. One-on-one, Randy Wood and Mike Richter. Final instructions from Koharski to Richter.
Every player on the ice is either on the bench or on the Islander side of center ice.
And every fan in the stands on their feet. 10:25 to go, second period. Rangers leading 1-0. Here comes Randy Wood.
Shot. Diddick was caught flat-footed, upended Jansen's, and the Rangers go on the power play. Sam, go back to that penalty shot for a moment. Wood's a right winger. He went down the right side of the ice. To me, that took away some of his options to work on Richter. Kind of surprised that he didn't go right down the middle, that he had more options available to him.
The pressure by Fred Sutter, and the Rangers move out. Patrick, Turcotte, Nichols, Gartner, and Wilson for the power play. Nyland, Crosby, Sutter, and Flatley for the Islanders, and the Islander penalty killing has been superb in this game. Patrick. Now Turcotte across, takes a hit with a stick from Patrick Flatley. James Patrick, long shot deflected up off the glass. Nichols, checked by Flatley. Turcotte. James Patrick. Turcotte. Nichols, the shot. Wilson moving it behind the net. Gartner goes for it. Gary Nyland on him. Across to Turcotte. Patrick. Down low is Mike Gartner. Wilson. Turcotte. Long shot to the left side. Nichols trying to get it in front. Blocked by Crosby. Nichols gets help with a pick from Gartner. Nichols looking. Three men down low. set up down low against Fitzpatrick. Long shot by Nichols, tipped wide. Gardner on his knees, he's slitting across. James Patrick keeps it in. Rangers have done an outstanding job keeping the puck in the Islanders' zone.
And the Islanders have an outstanding job not allowing a clean shot.
12 seconds to go on the power play. Wilson goes across. Second period, Rangers leading 1-0. On a first period goal by Bernie Nichols. The pass across intended for Mullen. He gathers it back in center. Dexter for Mullen. It's tipped into the Islander zone. Yari Grunstrand back for it. Jeff Norton moves the puck out of the zone. The Rangers recover. Islanders 17 shots. Rangers 13. Rangers leading 1-0. Back to 7-7 here in the second period. 7:37 to go. Both goals for Washington. Driver for the Devils. Hartford on goals by Krieger and Evason, leading 2-0 in the second. Montreal a goal by Skruglund. Dean Kennedy scoring for Buffalo. Those are the other games in the Wales Conference playoff series. The Campbell Conference series resumes tomorrow night.
Sam, only the second time since 1972 that Montreal has opened on the road in a playoff series. They're playing without Chris Chelios, who may miss another 3 weeks yet before he's able to get back, because Montreal is still in the playoffs.
Hubie McDonough moving with the puck. Now Gerald Dittick and Jeff Finley. Richter leaves it behind the net. Roller gets to it, takes a hit from Lakota. Lakota on for the time, well, in a long time.
Because his team's either been on the power play or penalty killing, and he doesn't do either. So he's probably been sitting on the bench getting all calmed up and wants to go out and bang somebody. This kid would be in a similar position for the Rangers.
McDonough to Lakota for the shot, save made by Richter. The Lakota's had two good chances in this game. Richter stopped him by five. Hittick back for it, bangs it away. Here's Kissio for Mullen. Now the front is blocked. Good play by Jeff Finley. Long shot by Mullen. Save Fitzpatrick. The rebound. The front is shot is blocked. Kissio got knocked down. And the Islanders have the puck. Lakota. Behind the back pass to Mullen. Back for Lakota. In front is clear to Simon Oshkore. Rangers pull the zone.
Defenseman have been very strong in not allowing a Ranger player to a rebound. The Rangers now seem to be getting the low shots on Fitzpatrick, yet they can't get to any rebounds.
Ryan Mullen moving out. Sends it over the island. His own Rangers change. 6:15 to go in the second period. Rangers lead. Intercept by Nyland. Puts it in.
Shot, and it goes through. through Mike Richter, never beat him to the corner or up high. It went through his arm, between the arm and his body. And Brian Trottier with a big goal for the Islanders.
Future Hall of Famer comes through, giving the Islanders a much needed lift here. After the Rangers have scored the second goal of the game. After your goal coming less than a minute after the Rangers have scored.
Is Richard Pilon, a much missed defenseman for the New York Islanders. Real tough. Out with an eye injury. Suffered early in the season. The Islander goal is Trottier from Wood and Crossman at 14:36. Coming 47 seconds after the Rangers have scored. Wallach centers and is just missed by Brent Sutter. He's tied up by Mike Gartner. Flatley comes over. Norton was bumped by Millett. Brunstrand keeps it in. Brunstrand trying to tee up a shot, deflecting wide. Bullock was taken down. Roachbury around the tractor and then move the puck. The side of the line has had some great shifts here, even strength. Gartner moving in against York, pulls up. Gartner looks to make a play. Down low is blocked as Millett was tied up by Brunstrand. 4:20 to go in the second period. Flatley has it knocked aside. Bullock plays it across. Corner with Brent Sutter. Brent Sutter, oh so tough. Corner situation, digging, bumping. Dinnick plays it across. Jeff Gordon, wrist shot high off the glass. Around the board. Derek keeping the shot, saved by Richter. The rebound blocked by Richter. Alan Kerr got to it. Didn't get much wood on it though, and Richter able to glove it and hold on. 3:53 to go in the second period. Rangers with a 2-1 lead. Well, the greatest show on earth. I thought this was the greatest show on earth. No, it's the circus. Ringling Brothers, Barnum and Bailey Circus is in town, the 120th anniversary edition, premiering the Tognese, Italy's reigning circus family. That's the circus here at Madison Square Garden through April 29th. For ticket information, call 212-563-8300.
LaFontaine back on the ice for the Islanders. Randy Moeller back on the ice for the Rangers. Here you see the Islanders shooting from all different angles now. That was King with a rolling puck. He decided to put it towards the goal. Mike Richter was able to hang on to the rebound as Sutter was tied up nicely. But the Islanders not at all fancy the offensive zone here. And Trottier's goal will attest to that.
LaFontaine on a faceoff, setting Vidic behind him.
Islanders went four men up for the draw, Sam, in the offensive zone.
Kerr going for the puck. Roachbury is there and tries to move it out. It was kept in by Dinnick. Right on the line. Mullen able to work it out of the zone. Gary Nyland stopping. Puts it back in. Mullen plays it. Mullen through Wolf Rocket. Islanders have done a good job on this line. Mullen long shot stopped by Fitzpatrick. Almost caught the goaltender moving. Fitzpatrick able to make the stop. Gerald Dinnick plays it in. Side by Richter. Bloomberg is hit by LaFontaine. Derek King along the boards. Lost it. Bloomberg gets it to Kissio. Didn't bring it out. Here comes LaFontaine. Bloomberg comes back. Slows him down. Kerr. LaFontaine in front. Saved by Richter. Can't get him in the rebound. Kissio's got it.
Well, in a few shifts, LaFontaine's been out there. Not against Moeller or Patrick. And he had himself a pretty good scoring chance there.
Behind the play, LaFontaine and Brad Greschner. Stick wouldn't let go. He looked very closely at it, and then finally Greschner pulled free and play went on. Here comes Turcotte across the line. He shoots, saved by Fitzpatrick. Nyland and Turcotte on the board. Nyland moves it. McDonough goes over, able to clear the zone. 2.5 minutes to go, second period. 2-1 Rangers. Rangers have led since early in the first period. 1-0, and took a brief 2-0 lead.
This Ranger line has not had a chance to play much at even strength. Turcotte with Wilson and King because of all the specialty team play.
The cut out against Patrick. And Rory thought it was an offside. Rochefort takes out Maloney. Turcotte lifts the puck clear. Jeff Norton goes back for it. Good hit by Chris King. Following the second period, Bruce Beck will have Don Maloney as his guest in the studio. Page will be at the MSG Sports Date, the Sports Desk, the update on the scores and give you some NHL Stanley Cup playoff highlights. And John and I will take a look at second period highlights. Money is knocked away by Greschner. Jansen. Mark Jansen's goal. since February the 7th, but 25 games without a goal.
This is the 90th game that he has played in this season. 9 exhibition games, 80 during the regular season, and his first exhibition game.
To New Jersey, Pat Conacher scored for New Jersey to tie it at 2-2, and now the Caps have taken the lead again.
Dale Hunter scored 23 during the regular season. Here you see Hunter wind up. It looked like it deflected off the defenseman's stick, and Sean Burke had problems finding that shot. It went off the blade of the defenseman's stick up over top of Sean Burke.
Burke's given up a couple of shaky goals, and I wouldn't be surprised if Chris Terreri's in there for game two.
Well, that one's a long ways from over. Certainly, we've seen two goals, one through his legs, and that one a longer shot from a bad angle. It's interesting.
It'll be interesting to see how these coaches play it, but I think you're looking at a situation in New Jersey, in Boston, and here with the Rangers, where the coaches are likely to go with both of their goaltenders. Mike Milbury has already said he's going to rotate Logan Lamela.
A lot of pressure on the coaches to make the right decision. But think about this. 8 coaches coaching tonight, 5 of them in the first playoff game.
Pollock shot it wide. Flatley plays it to Pollock. Taken out by Grechner. Moeller trying to work it free. Flatley is there, working the boards well. As he one guy is kept in by Jeff Gordon. Feeds Flatley. He shoots. Good save by Rick Pierre. Position for a shot.
You'll see this line, I'm telling you, at even strength, have been working, and especially the boards. Look at Flatley get set and snap it quick, and it just doesn't look any better than that. The radar gun goes up to catch that one. Flatley, once he got it back to North, turned to accept the pass, and it snapped it. And Flatley, who is the quiet leader for the New York Islanders, having an outstanding game here, as is his line, Sam, at even strength. That's a third solid shift they've had this period, and Mike Richter has been the difference with them.
The only place he's not quiet is along the boards. You hear the boards rattle every time he hits you.
And he's smart when he slashes, and he uses the stick a lot to clear people away from him when he checks, but he does it in a smart fashion and very seldom gets called for it. You think of the Islanders' scoring chances this period. Most of them have been that line. Sutter with a couple, Volek, that time Flatley.
Islanders with 13 shots on goal here in the second. Rangers have 11. 23-17 for the game for the Islanders, but the Rangers lead 2-1 with 57 seconds remaining in the second period. Still loose in the circle, and looks like Janssens is on top of it. We'll have another faceoff.
Now that's an example of what I meant by the teams being schooled on how to work on faceoffs. A lot of times centermen will battle the other centermen to a draw, to a tie, then there's a loose puck. And so teams have to battle to get in there. There you see the two centermen. Janssens trying to neutralize his man. Trottier comes in to try and bowl everybody out of the way to find the loose puck. Janssens does it again. This time the Islanders are ready for it.
Trottier centering pass comes all the way through, and Eriksson gets out with the puck. Norton has it. Now Trottier, nice tip to Randy Wood, coming in against Rochefort. Looked up by James Patrick. Trottier goes back to Dinnick. It deflects high over the glass and into the crowd, and play stops with 28 seconds to go.
The last time Al Arbor hosted a playoff series was 85-86. Lost all 3 games to Washington that year, outscored 11-4. But his playoff record? 113 wins, 69 losses. 11 of those games, by the way, was when he was coaching in St. Louis with the Blues before he became the legend that he is with the Islanders.
And as we said before, the biggest number is 4. 4 Stanley Cups.
Again, Donnie Maloney just raves about him, saying he's the best coach he's ever worked for or played for because he's able to combine both teaching and communication.
Janssens on the faceoff against Brent Sutter this time. Rochefort takes the puck. James Patrick has some room. Broken up by Flatley. And the Rangers go back to chase. 15 seconds to go on the period. Brent Sutter forechecking for the Islanders. Rochefort looks around. Sends out James Patrick. Island sends it in, and that'll do it for the second period. Each team with a goal in the second. The Islanders with a very important goal. Less than a minute later, Ryan Trottier scored at 14:36, and it's 2-1 Rangers, end of two. The Rangers heading off the ice, and right downstairs outside the locker room is Bruce Beck. Bruce?
Thank you, Sam. When the game began, it was all about emotion. Now the focus is execution and intensity. Gary Wilson told me before the game that the bottom line tonight is that we must outwork a team that thrives on the work ethic. And thus far, the Rangers have done just exactly that, limiting the opportunities of Pat LaFontaine. Coming up between periods, I'll talk to Don Maloney, now with the New York Islanders. Now we'll check in at the MSG Sports Desk. Back at the Garden with more
Good We Really Are. Jensen's at 13:49, Trotsky at 14:36. Shots on goal. Second period, Islanders 14, total 24, Rangers 11, total 17. In that second period, a penalty shot for Randy Wood of the Islanders.
19:35 of the period. I was very surprised that Wood went to the right and then back to his left. And Mike Richter with a save with the leg at 9:35 of the period. Here's John Van Beesbrink looking on, and the team celebrates from the bench after Mike Richter makes the big, big, big save.
Remember, when you're having good times with good friends, use good sense and drink responsibly. Please know when to say when. A reminder from your friends at Anheuser-Busch. Mike Richter, his first start against the Islanders. He played the third period of a 5-5 tie here in Madison Square Garden. The Rangers rallying from a 5-2 deficit to tie it. Billy Smith on your right, Bill Torrey on the left. In the background is Richard Pilon as the Islanders look on.
Billy Smith is living out in the state of Washington, just south of Vancouver, British Columbia. And I might have to move up there, Sam, because whatever he's doing, his hair's growing again.
And he's getting younger. He looks great.
I need it.
Underway in the third. Troy Millett had to go off his stick. Brent Sutter has the puck and moves it up the boards to Patrick Flyman. Millett taking it back. Nichols moving in against Brent Sutter. Sutter stays with him. Dinnick getting it ahead for Flatley. Wallach in the middle. A crisscross. Flatley triple team. And it's chopped out of the zone by Gartner. Game two will be Saturday night. And we'll have it for you right here on MSG Network. We'll be on the air at 8 o'clock with Rangers game night. Game time at 8:30. Two-line pass will be against the Islanders. This program is authorized by Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or the use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the program, without the expressed written consent of Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated, is prohibited.
Well, John O'Gradnick here playing in this game. His wife, Betty Ann, who is expecting, is sitting in the stands watching. And his daughter, Kelsey Ann, is at home watching. She turned 6 today. And John and Betty Ann said to say, happy birthday.
And we'll be home with birthday cake after the game. Gary Nylund holding away from Ryan Mullen. Nice pass to LaFontaine. In against Rochefort. Nice poke check by Rochefort. A good poke check by O'Gradnick to get it out of the zone. Now Rochefort with the puck for James Patrick. O'Gradnick, Lee DeCicco, tries to control it, back in, and knocked over the blocker by Fitzpatrick. O'Gradnick, DeCicco, DeCicco looking, backhands it behind the net, Gary Nylund there to intercept. Rochefort, blocked by LaFontaine. Mullen's got the puck to Kelly DeCicco, drives it in.
You should mention that during the regular season, the third periods, the Rangers outscored the Islanders 11-5.
Trying to take it away from Randy Wood. Chris King plays it in. Turcotte, King, and Wilson on for the Rangers. Maloney with a lead from Dubé McDonough. McDonough holds up. Pass back for Norton. Broken up. Good play by King. He's taken out of the play by Makota. Richter. Pass deflected. Richter gets it back. 2 minutes gone by. Third period. 2-1. Rangers lead it.
Is trying to rotate Norton every second shift. He loves to move in on the offense.
King rising up with a big shot that went off the stick of Fitzpatrick. That shot by Wilson's near the side. King is going to go. Penalty call. Interference to call. King took down Vakota. Islanders get a power. Chris King in the penalty box, and the Islanders get their fourth power play of the game.
You'll see it on the near boards. Once this shot goes wide, Chris King. It's kicked wide by Fitzpatrick. King and Vakota will meet along the boards. And King put a stick down around the legs of Vekota. Down he went. And the Islanders, who trailed by one, go to work. LaFontaine, Sutter, and King up front. Watch Kratzman on the point move in if they get an opportunity in the offensive zone.
Looking at Vekota on the bench. Rochefort sending it all the way down. Jansons, Erickson, Rochefort, and Patrick on for the Rangers. Islanders with LaFontaine, Derek King, Sutter, Norton, and Crossman. Patrick breaks up the pass intended for Brent Sutter and sent all the way back. Jeff Norton carry. Looks around. LaFontaine brings it in. Picked up briefly. An offside was whistled against the Islanders. They'll bring it outside the zone. 30 seconds gone in the power play opportunity.
You were talking with LaFontaine before the game, and he said some interesting things about how he's more of a principal now in the playoffs.
It's interesting. He said how quickly time has passed, that it's 6 years since their last meeting with the Rangers. And he said in that series, he was sitting on the bench learning and watching. He just joined the Islanders.
Still calls him Mr. Rosen.
Quite a guy.
He's a classy young man, I'll tell you that.
He can call me anything he wants.
Let him know.
Sutter, LaFontaine, and King. Mullen, Kissio on with Rochefort and Patrick. Norton gets into the Rangers zone, but Patrick, good check. Sutter off the stick of LaFontaine and cleared out by Kissio. Mullen gets to the puck. Crossman for Derek King. Now Crossman heading for the Rangers zone. Lead pass to Brent Sutter. Through, save by Richter. Pretty pass from Norton to Sutter.
Sutter has a sneaky delivery with a shot.
Norton with a shot wide. Rochefort drives it up the board, stopped by Crossman. That pass comes to Crossman. Now it's King with the shot blocked by Rochefort, and it carries out of the zone. 40 seconds to go on the Islander power play. Derek King wheels it around the glass, bounces down. And cleared out of the zone by Kissio. Then he tried to leapfrog over Jeff Norton. Climbed up on his back. Crossman for Derek King. Slowed down. Pass knocked down by Turcotte. Good hands, and he cleared the zone.
Rangers using five different forwards here, killing a penalty. Erickson out every, actually more than any other forward to kill a penalty. Erickson with Jansons. Here he's on the ice now with Turcotte.
Norton coming in against Muller. Norton goes around the center, and the shot goes high over the top.
At touchofmodern.com, we get that the things you surround yourself with reflect who you are. Your style, your drive, your passions. Venture through a curated collection of astonishing items at touchofmodern.com, because sometimes things aren't just things, they're you. Go to touchofmodern.com and discover the world's most unexpected items.
We now move ahead in the action.
Great setup and another good rush by Jeff Norton. Power play is over.
That's one thing the Rangers have to watch now since they have the lead. Norton and Crossman will join the rush a lot. Bad offense.
Over to the shot to save by Fitzpatrick. Out comes Randy Wood. Rangers leading 2-1. Maloney tied up along the board, still has it. Hits for the net. Maloney stopped by Rochefort. Randy Wood tied up with Jan Erickson. Erickson able to get it to Turcotte. The Rangers come out. 15:20 to go. Third period. Rangers leading 2-1. The Islanders now 0-4 on the power play. The power play goals in this game. Gardner went flying as Rochefort waited for Finley and the collision, and Rochefort went down, checking his teeth.
Yes, not his knee. That's the best thing about that crash and collision. David Smith quickly across. Rochefort hit up high in the face. The Rangers moving back as Rochefort moved up to hit Finley. He seemed to lose his balance. Gardner had gone down. Rochefort took the blunt of the blow right to the head. Finley a little dazed on the play too. Quite a collision as all three players appear to go off balance.
Rochefort gets up. Seems to be okay. 15:08 to go. Third period. Rangers leading 2-1.
Andrews has scored for Washington. The Caps leading 4-2. Hartford leading Boston 4-2 in that game, with Lemelin in goal for the Bruins, and Buffalo leading Montreal 4-1. Kennedy 5, Andrechuk and Corkum scoring for Buffalo. Skruglund for Montreal. Hartford on goals by Krieger, Everson, Young, and Ladouceur.
For Montreal, Richer playing with a very sore hip pointer. He says it does affect his shot. Ludwig, by the way, is playing.
Millett with a shot that just went wide. Maloney's got the puck. Maloney trying to work away from Gartner. Didick got it out of the zone. McDonough plays it in. Moves it around. Millett with a bump with Didick, and the puck all the way down into the Islander zone. Gary Nyland back for it. Now it's Gretzky. Rangers leading 2-1. Nickel scoring in the first period. Jansen's in the second. Trotche for the Islanders. Bernie Nichols, offside Rangers. 14:20 to go in the third period. Bernie Nichols scoring the first Ranger goal in the 6th minute of play. And there is the former Ranger, Don Maloney. And he was excited about the game. The fans get into it. He was really excited about playing, and I think things have settled down. He's adjusted to life as an Islander now. And he hopes to be an Islander next year. As Bill Torrey said, he will make a decision later. Rochefort, by the way, has a cracked tooth, and what that can do is present a problem with his breathing. If it's a cracked tooth and a nerve is exposed, breathing the cool air as he skates can be very, very painful. Now, the Rangers do have their band of dentists here, and they can do some quick fix that work. Dr. Solomon or Miller the Driller, the cavity filler, they get down there and help him out.
Patrick Flatley across the line. Pass for Bollock. Trying to tee up a shot, but Kerry Wilson all over. Gretzky, nice touch pass to King. Chris King moving out with Darren Turcotte. Jeff Norton takes it off the boards. Boys, Chris King. Islanders move out of the zone. Gretzky stops them in center. Turcotte's got it. Jeff Norton. Flatley tapping it to LaFontaine and getting it back. Randy Moeller. He's seen a lot of ice time in this game. Moves it around the boards for Chris King. 13:25 to go in the third. Rangers leading 2-1 as King fires in. Knocked away casually with a blocker by Mark Fitzpatrick. Inbound Gartner. Stopped by Richter. James Patrick. The team's being very careful here. Derek King with a takeaway. Now it's Alan Kerr shooting off the stick of Richter. Baumgartner hit by Moeller. LaFontaine centers for Kerr. The shot blocked by Patrick, and out of the zone it goes. What a pass from LaFontaine to Kerr, who set him up high in the slot. Kerr moving in. Jansen stops it, moves it up the boards, and it's blocked again by Alan Kerr. Jansen's and Kerr along the boards. Erickson trying to dig it free, and a whistle stops play. The faceoff will be outside the zone. 12:30. Furnished by Pierre Cardin, available at Carlin's at all major malls throughout New Jersey. Rangers on with Nichols, Millett, Gartner, Bloomberg, and Greschner. Nichols wins the draw from McDonough. McDonough, Vakota, and Maloney on opposite the Nichols line. Maloney with a takeaway is bumped by Bernie Nichols. Roughed up a little bit by Bloomberg, but he battles both of them. And the Rangers finally have the puck. Mike Gartner. Patrick loving the short hop. Jeff Norton moves it around the boards. Kept in by Gretzky for the long shot. Locked in front. McDonough looking for it. Millett's got it. Saved by Fitzpatrick. Covers the rebound.
Good save by Fitzpatrick. And now he has pushing and shoveling with Millett along with Vakona. I'm not so sure the Islanders can play any better than what they are right now. So they played a fine game in here and quite a battle with the Rangers. Today, the supervisor of officials, pardon me, will take a look at this shot here first. As you see the shot by Millett. Fitzpatrick was down, made the save look pretty easy, actually. There's Millett and Vakona battling. Supervisor of officials for this series, John D'Amico, was in, and he measured all the goaltending equipment. They found that Fitzpatrick and Richter's catching gloves
the top of their gloves on the inside, you see that wide part?
Yeah.
That is supposed to be 8 inches. Both goaltenders had the width at 9 inches, illegal. So the training staff had to go to work, Jimmy Pickard along with Tim Paris, and they had to take those gloves apart and cut them down to make sure they were legal to play in this game. If they couldn't get the job done, those goaltenders couldn't use those gloves, and that would have been uncomfortable for the two netminders.
Those sneaky goalies looking for an extra inch.
Imagine that. I never used to do that. Wasn't smart enough.
Ogrodnik across the line. Wrist shot is high off the glass. Islanders have done an excellent job on the Kissio Mullen Ogrodnik line. And whistle stops play. Stick with the puck was touched with a stick above the shoulder. 11:45 to go in the third period. Rangers holding on to a 2-1 lead. Bernie Nichols at 5:14 of the first period. Jansen's at 13:49 of the second. And Trottier at 14:36 of the second.
We mentioned earlier about Al Arbour when he last coached in a playoff series. The last time Roger Nielsen was in a playoff series was in 82-83. He lost the best of five series, 3-1 to Calgary. His lifetime record going into tonight's game, 24-24.
Rangers were eliminated in the first round in four straight last year. The year before, they failed to make the playoffs. And the year before that, they were eliminated in the first round by the Flyers in six. Have to go back to 1986. For the last time the Rangers got past the first round, when they went to the Stanley Cup semifinals. Wallach in the corner, but he was moved by Ogrodnik. Bloomberg pounded by Brent Sutter.
Yeah, this play should have been icing, but Mike Richter touched the puck before Bloomberg got to it, negating the icing, and the Islanders have put pressure on since. Good work along the board. Flatley got it back to Crosby. The shot deflected wide of the net. Dangerous shot as it fluttered in. Wallach was knocked down. Sutter working against Ogrodnik, who poked it free.
And Mullen able to clear the zone. 10:45 to go in the third period. Crossman across was bumped by Gresher. Flatley and Mullen in the corner. Good play by Mullen, allowing Bloomberg to take the puck. Back into the Rangers zone. James Patrick picks it up. Both teams changing. Patrick picks up speed, feeds Erickson. Patrick heads for the net. The pass back to Patrick. Backhander in front is loose. Still loose. Rangers looking for it. And it's knocked aside. LaFontaine for Krejci. Broken up by Mulder. Good play. Norton goes back for it. Erickson chasing him. Jeff Norton looks up ice. LaFontaine picks up the puck. Midway point, third period. 10 minutes to go. Rangers 2, Islanders 1. Patrick back for it. He's stopped by LaFontaine. Chris Nylund on the ice, able to clear the zone. Now it's Norton for LaFontaine. Leaves it for Randy Wood. Patrick takes it, moves it up the boards. Islanders keep it in. Patrick has it back. Back and forth they go, up and down the boards. Rangers clear the zone, and the Islanders come out to play. Gary Nylund. McDonough met by Wilson. Stopped and sent it into the Rangers zone. Richter moves it along the boards. Stopped by Randy Wood. Diddick moving it down low for Maloney. Back pass for Nylund. Down low, McDonough was tied up by Bloomberg, and Bloomberg plays it around the boards, but not out. Kept in by Randy Wood. Wood on the move, using his speed. Knocked down by Turcotte, a man with equal speed. Nylund trying to keep it in, was blocked by Wilson. Here comes Turcotte one-on-one against Gerald Diddick. Turcotte goes in on the move, and he shot it wide, and slides into the goaltender. Rangers try to keep it in, and a whistle stops play. 8:50 to go. Third period. Rangers leading 2-1.
Yes, the first word to any adventure. But when allergies and congestion strike, take Allegra D, a non-drowsy antihistamine plus a powerful decongestant. So you can always say yes to putting your true colors on display. Say yes to Allegra D.
At AutoZone, you get what you need when you need it. Got a today job? Pick it up free same day at your local AutoZone. More of a tomorrow project? Order as late as 10 p.m. with free next day delivery. Getting the job done just got easier.
Here's Ovechkin. Scoring for three. Bang! And the Knicks take the lead.
some sort of panic on the bench. His right skate is giving him a problem. He just took a turn on the ice, Sam, and he had it all taped up. There was tape all around the skate. It's like a football player taping up his ankle on his cleats during football season. It looks now like Gresser's got to take the skate off and have some repair done to it inside the equipment room.
And the Rangers already without Norman Rochefort.
So they're down to four right now, with Rochefort in the locker room and Gresser unable to play because of an equipment problem.
Islanders were offside on the play. 8:32 to go in the third period. Now Rangers leading 2-1.
Here's Gresner getting the new skate, I believe, on, or the old skate off, one or the other. You have to remember that that is the foot, Sam. You see how gingerly he's taking it off? That's a right foot. His little toe was the toe that was fractured. Here he's having trouble getting the skate off. Now, players always have two or three pairs of skates. His skate has been widened to try and get that foot in. So I imagine that his extra pair, the right skate, would be a problem for him to get on. So here he will probably have to wait to get the skate repaired.
Randy Moeller fires it out to John Ogrodnik. Kissio left it, but Kerr takes it back for the Islanders.
Now Tim Paris, the equipment man, has gone to the locker room with Greschner's right skate. Greschner is now trying to put on another right skate.
Moeller breaks up the play, but it's stolen by King. He sets up in front. Lafontaine fanned on the shot, and it's cleared aside. Big chance for Pat Lafontaine, and he fanned on it. Fitzpatrick plays it into the crowd. It's a penalty automatic. A careless play by the goaltender. It gives the Rangers a power play. The puck was...
All right. Yeah, he does, believe me.
Mark Fitzpatrick draws a delay of the game penalty at 12:05.
Sam Fitzpatrick has to cross his hands on the stick. There you see he's got his right hand down low this time. The puck flipped up as he went to shoot it, and it went directly into the stands. It did not redirect off of the glass or off a player, so it's an automatic penalty. There you see him just flick his wrist, but with the puck rolling, the Rangers get the chance to go on the power play.
And the towels are waving in Madison Square Garden. The Rangers leading 2-1. They're 0-6 on the power play. Patrick down low, deflected by Gardner. Right of the net. Flatly with Brent Sutter, Gary Nyland, and Doug Crosman. Rangers with Wilson, Gardner, Nichols, Patrick, and Turcotte. Flatly meets Patrick. Turcotte has the puck. James Patrick. Taken away by Brent Sutter.
Sutter and McDonough had three shorthanded goals apiece during the regular season. Of the Islanders, 10. And they would love to get one here as they trail by one goal.
Turcotte looks up ice. 7:10 remaining, third period. Rangers leading 2-1 and on a power play. Would have been a two-line pass. Here's a setup for Turcotte. His pass is blocked by Gary Nyland. Crossman moves it to Maloney. Blocked by Bluebird. Kept in by Wilson. Bouncer wide of the net. Nyland drives it up the boards. And Turcotte trying to keep it in with his skate, but missed.
Speaking of skates, Gresner just now looks like he's able to join the Rangers on the ice if he needs to. He's finally got that new skate on his right foot.
Mullen on now with Nichols and Ogrodnik. Down the boards for Nichols. Dinnick comes over. It off the boards. Mullen stops it. Plays it for Nichols. It was blocked. Now Horschebeck the point. Long shot blocked by Randy Wood. Here's a lead for Wood. Slowed down by Horschebeck. I think if Wood dives there, he might have drawn a penalty.
The Islanders will use Wood and Lafontaine a lot, killing penalties when they trail.
Nichols comes in. It's deflected across out of the zone.
Now, Sam, with Wood's speed, he can even things up, or he can try and get a scoring chance.
Moeller moves back in. Moeller whacked by Dinnick. Set up in front for Ogrodnik, deflected wide. Final seconds of the power play. Teams are back at full strength. 5:55 to go. Moeller pulled down by Dinnick. Puck cleared out of the zone. Rangers 0-7 on the power play. Kissio moves in against Dinnick. He shoots. Save Fitzpatrick. Rebound cleared aside by Nyland. Gary Nyland has had himself an outstanding game. That was Jeff Norton, excuse me, who cleared that rebound. But Nyland is still quite an outstanding game. Here's a shot. Save. with Horschelot and Bloomberg back. LaFontaine with a drop pass intended for Kerr. Right off the boards. Good play by Erickson. Trying to move it up the boards. He's tied up. Set up for LaFontaine. The shot blocked by Bloomberg. Kerr working against Erickson. Islanders press to keep it in the zone, and they do. Derek King has the puck. Sends it across. Tipped by Bloomberg. Good chip for Jeff Bloomberg. LaFontaine working it for Kerr in the corner against Erickson. 4:40 to go in the third. The pass back is out of the zone.
LaFontaine has been held without a point to this point in this game.
Orchard able to clear. Richter stops it. Orchard looks up ice with 4:25 to go. Rangers have done an excellent defensive job here in the third period. The Islanders have had only three shots on goal. And they have 4:15 remaining in the third.
Trying to control the neutral zone here. Just like that, Chris King intercepting the pass as the Islanders move up ice. Not so much offensive pressure in the Islanders zone, more pressure in the neutral zone.
Gary Nyland, long shot deflected wide. It was tipped. And now, Patrick finally went down. I don't know if he was hit by a stick or by Gressler. Gressler's back on the ice. Finally goes back at Gressler. Finally went down holding his head, and then got up and continued to play. 3:45 to go in the third. Rangers lead 2-1. Brent Sutter moves across. By the center of his block. Rangers driven out. Turcotte by himself. Just dumps it in. Dumped it in deep, knowing that his team and his line needed a change. And that's a key to a clean change. Get the puck deep. It allows you no time. And the ball will lead for Brent Sutter. Sutter looking. Center down goal with a save made by Richter.
Sam Sutter's line, which had a great second period, appears to be a little more tired in this third period. They don't have the tenacity in the offensive zone that they had in the second period.
Norton moves it up the boards and out. LaFontaine going for it. Patrick stopped it. Vissio. Islanders almost caught changing. 2:50 to go in the third period. 2-1 Rangers. O'Gladnik keeps it in. Dinnick takes it. They will fire across. Hockey tied up by Brian Muller. Patrick gets it to Kessio. Gartner couldn't handle the pass. Gressler helps out. Now Mike Gartner. And then against Gary Nyland. Gartner by himself plays it out of the zone. Nichols has it. Fires in. Gary Nyland back to play. Icing is called on the Rangers. Nichols serves it in for the Rangers side of the red line. 2:21 to go in the third.
He received a couple of stitches in his upper lip. He has a chipped tooth. Will not return, but expect him back for game two. Back upstairs to Sam Rosen and John Davidson.
And the pressure on the Rangers defense.
And Gressner now making another change, getting his original skate back. And he's had to hustle with that. Actually, Gressner got it back to the bench. He's on the ice, so he hasn't made the change.
Muller moves it around the boards. Norton stops it. Deflected by Gartner. Played by Alan Curry. Bumped by Muller. Nichols picks up the puck. Banks it off the boards. Kept in by Doug Crosman. Then blocked by Nichols. Rangers able to clear the zone. 2 minutes to go in regulation time. Rangers lead 2-1. And the puck put over the boards into the Rangers bench. Stops play with a minute 55 to go. Nichols was entangled with Alan Curry. And Millett once again at Curry. You saw what Nichols said, you backstabber.
Yeah. Wrong ways from the play, and a dangerous play by Kerr. He's lucky he got away with it.
When you think of a bank, you think of people in a place. But when you have the Chase mobile app, your bank can be virtually any place. So when you get a check, you can deposit it from here. And you can see your transactions and check your balance from here. You can save for an emergency from here. Or pay bills from here. So when someone asks you, where's your bank? You can tell them, here's my bank, or here's my bank, or here's my bank. Because if you download and use the Chase mobile app, your bank is virtually any place. Visit chase.com/mobile.
When we first opened our doors, it didn't take us long to realize.
We weren't in the car business.
At Lexus, we were in the people business.
We needed to be helpful.
Respectful.
And compassionate.
To treat people like guests.
It's what we all signed up for.
And now when people need this most, We will do what we've always done.
Take care of people first.
The rest will follow.
The veteran Nichols talking with Troy Millett, who was ready to come to his aid.
Yes, he was, but the Rangers lead by one goal with 1:55 remaining, and Roger Nielsen made the line change. I think it's smart. You don't want anybody to get caught taking a penalty when you have the lead. That's something that Kerr would love to have happen. I'm sure that's part of his plan when he knocked down Nichols.
1:45 to go in the third. 2-1 Rangers. Game one of the best of seven series. Game two is Saturday night. We'll be on the air with game night at 8 o'clock. Doug Foster. 1:25 to go. Picked up by Maloney. Gets in. Hit check by Grester. Good check by James Patrick. Knocks down the 5-10. He's shaking up on the line.
He got hit twice.
He's motionless on the ice.
He looked like he jammed his head into Chris Nyland. I did see his legs move a little bit, but he's got a problem here. And they're calling for another trainer and the doctor quickly.
Oh, my goodness.
And you just hope he doesn't swallow his tongue. He's been knocked motionless. He was sandwiched between two Ranger players and the training staff quickly trying to do a job. It's Pat LaFontaine down for the Islanders, and we hope everything's all right here.
Patrick came over with a hard hit, and then Nyland was there as well.
The training staff were on the ice in a matter of seconds to try and help LaFontaine, who was motionless. Now Dr. Minkoff, two Islander doctors on the ice surface, and they now get to Pat LaFontaine, and they can take over here once Patrick, the defenseman, there you see LaFontaine's got his eyes open now and appears to be coming around somewhat. When you lay on your back like that, Sam, and you're knocked out, the chance of swallowing your tongue is very, very severe or serious. And the training staff was there quickly. Patrick and Nyland, the original check was by James Patrick. And then it looked like LaFontaine was stood up somewhat. You'll watch it here. You'll see the first check is Greshner on Flatley. LaFontaine's going into the middle, looks up. Patrick, with a shoulder to the right side of the head. Oh, my. Very similar to Tony Granato last year in Toronto when he caught the shoulder of Luke Richardson and was out cold before he got onto the ice surface.
And the stretcher being brought out.
Well, LaFontaine's head was jarred and turned with that body check, and it appeared to be a clean check, the shoulder of James Patrick. It appeared as though he kept his elbow down and close to his body and hit LaFontaine with the shoulder.
The positive sign is that he is conscious. Just can only hope that not a serious injury to a great player and a great person.
As great a player as he is, he's even a better person, this young man. Watch James Patrick move across. Look at the right shoulder. Boom.
Oh, man. What a hit. And then he lands hard, snapping his head. It's something you see in boxing when a boxer goes down.
As though he was probably out before he hit the ice surface. And it appeared to be the shoulder of James Patrick. Dr. Nissenson, the Ranger doctor, on the ice, too, as LaFontaine getting lots of medical attention. You can certainly tell that the trainers from both teams, the doctors from both teams, getting on the ice surface quickly.
There's a minute 17 remaining in the third period. The Rangers are leading 2-1, and Pat LaFontaine injured on the play. Hope that this is not anything serious. The Islander coaching staff discussing things. There's always been hard hitting in this rivalry, and especially in the playoffs. You recall the big hit of Patrick Flatley on Barry Beck that really was the beginning of the end of Barry Beck's career.
The shoulder, yes. I again would like to congratulate Mark Aldridge, the Islander trainer, for getting out there so quickly. And then David Smith helped him, and then the doctors, and
the doctors from
paramedics.
Both teams are out there, the trainers from both
not
teams.
Not taking any chance. That's a head injury and possibly something worse. We certainly hope not. The whole building here kind of stunned as you see the player LaFontaine down, and he will be attended to here.
It's been a good, clean game.
Yes, and very little pushing and shoving after whistles. Very little stick work. Kaharski called all the stick work early in the first period, and the players got smart, got rid of it.
And this just a big, big collision between Patrick and LaFontaine.
And now the stretcher on the rollers is brought out. Right now they have immobilized Pat LaFontaine. He'll be lifted onto the other stretcher. Rangers leading 2-1 with a minute 17 remaining. The concern on the face of James Patrick.
But the fans responding here, Sam, very, very nicely.
As they should. You're looking at one of the best players in the National Hockey League.
They have a brace around the neck of LaFontaine now to really make sure that he is well looked after. And let's all think about some special thoughts and wish all the best to LaFontaine.
Yeah. I just hope that most of that we're seeing is precautionary. I would hope that that's all that is. Certainly doesn't look good, but I can only wish that he'll be back in a hurry. James Patrick with a hard hit, the shoulder.
1:17 on the clock here in the third period, a 2-1 Ranger lead. Now Al Arbor has to mix the deck a little bit and try and come up with some different combinations to fill in for LaFontaine.
And then certainly he is thinking about the final seconds of regulation time, when he will pull the goaltender for an extra skater. The faceoff will be outside the Ranger blue line. Rangers have Kissio, Mullen, Ogrodnik, Patrick, and Greschner on. Islanders with Sutter, Flatley, Volek, Norton, and Crossman.
And Volek is way over on the near boards. And Greschner moved across. The Islanders are going to attack. Fitzpatrick is out at the hash marks now.
Deep in the Rangers zone. Patrick back for it. Moves it quickly. Ogrodnik tied up by Crossman. Able to clear the zone. Norton's got the puck. Rangers with a 2-1 lead. Flatley has it. 1 minute to play in the third period.
On the ice.
Greschner and Patrick, along with Jansen's.
The dance card
may be a little full here.
I just hope it doesn't erupt into anything. That would.
Cal Arbor put his muscle guys on with 2 seconds left. The Rangers have the option. Do you counter with less small players and take the chance of injury, or do you match your big guys against them? And Roger Nielsen had to match his big guys here, and if he put smaller guys on, they could be injured.
Got Bloomberg, Greschner, Nyland, Jansen, and King. 2 seconds to go. A face-off for the Rangers. Will win.
See, the Rangers are lined up way back at top of the circle to try and stay away from the garbage. The linesmen are poised. Everybody in the building knows something.
Smart move. Smart move.
And I hope nothing does start.
And that's it. And the Islanders looking for Coma. Look at that jerk.
Just sickening.
I'm telling you, the Islanders are Bloomberg.
Islanders look like garbage on this play.
What a
goal. After him, Ryan Gardner leveled Chris King.
What
the Rangers
disgrace.
Didn't want this, and the Islanders look like garbage on this play.
This
he saw it coming, and this is something.
Mick Fecoda's side is right at Bloomberg. That's a disgrace.
Absolutely. Now here we go. Fitzpatrick, the goaltender, is in there. I'll tell you what, the Islanders on this particular set of plays.
Look at Fecoda's going on, and King is going over, and King can't get in there because he picked a third man in.
That doesn't matter now, Sam.
What a disgrace.
Now this is something. Now Richter's down to Fitzpatrick. The Islanders on this particular play, it was a clean hit on LaFontaine. On this play, I'll tell you, it's just not showing any class whatsoever.
Just mars what was an outstanding
hockey
game.
The bench, one of the Islander players reaching over, grabbing Chris Nyland from behind.
That's really, it takes a lot of guts.
Diddick's in there now, I'll tell you. To me, I can't. The Islanders have a tradition of great class and great play. They have tarnished themselves right here.
This is a disgrace. I'm just appalled. I can't stand this.
And Chris King going at it with Baumgartner. It wasn't hard to figure out this was going to happen. The Rangers wanted no part of it. They didn't even line up on the faceoff circle. The Islanders charged them and jumped them. No class.
They should be ashamed for what they did to disgrace an excellent hockey game.
Islanders showing absolutely no class whatsoever. And very, very hard for me to stomach what I'm seeing here. Very difficult.
What are they trying to prove?
An organization with great tradition and class showing nothing here.
See, this is the stuff that just disgusts me.
Now, Sam, Roger Nielsen had to counter with his big players, or Baumgartner and those guys would have jumped smaller.
Well, look where they were. They moved away. Just saying, we're not going to mix it up. Drop the puck, finish the game, and get out of here.
That's right. It's so evident. It's so obvious. It's disgusting.
This is what the league needs to get rid of. Jeff Bloomberg took a beating from that jerk Fecoda.
I know.
For what reason? For what reason?
Because Al Arbor put him on there to do it, to tell you the truth. And the Rangers wanted no part of it. The Islanders, now, what I'm saying is, Roger Nielsen had to put his bigger players out there because if he didn't, the Islanders would have attacked the small players.
But they weren't there. There was no confrontation until Fecoda skated right to Bloomberg and started punching
him. There would have been a confrontation whether the big players were there or the little players were there. That's the point. And that's disgusting.
And the league, you see, in my mind, the league should just suspend those guys.
I am a big Al Arbor fan, but Al Arbor's responsible for this.
A lot of guts to do that.
Right. It's disgusting. It's really disgusting. It demeans our game. It demeans our game because this will be across the country tomorrow.
That's it. This was an outstanding game. And now you know it sets the tone for the second game because you know that's what it's going to
and
start
Sam,
with.
And Sam, this goes back to the injury. This goes back to the injury of LaFontaine. It was a clean hit by Patrick. And it's a situation, there was no maliciousness involved. Nobody wanted to hurt LaFontaine. Gosh, I guess not. But this is disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
It just ruined a superb hockey game.
And the Islanders played well in this game.
Played very well. It's what playoff hockey was all about. And now the cheers cascade down for the New York Rangers, who have won game one, 2-1. And again, what it does is the post-game reports and questions will all deal with the nonsense, the ugliness, instead of dealing with the way this game was played, with intensity, with hitting, with excellent goaltending.
Disgusting.
With excellent defense.
Absolutely disgusting. As low as it gets in this league.
The New York
Rangers have defeated the Islanders 2-1. The final shots on goal, Islanders 29, Rangers 26. Al Arbor and Brent Sutter talking things over. Brent Sutter got the word from the referee as penalties were announced at the conclusion of the game. Rangers lead the best of seven series. One game to none. We'll be back with our post-game wrap-up.